I met Javier last year in a festival, a poetry festival in Struga, Macedonia. And it was a strange experience because we were around 150 poets, no?
Yes.
From all over the world, including Australia, Chile, you know, the other side of the antipodes. We had all come to this village in the south of Macedonia by a lake, a really nice place, thinking that we were going to read our poetry. And for a whole week, we didn't know when we're going to read, where, what, how long, with who, you know. And then they would take us to a park and say, "You're reading in 5 minutes." And we had no idea if they're going to read the translation. But it was very disorganized. We were there to make up the numbers. It was a poetry festival so important as a publicity stunt and a touristic gimmick that the festival was more important than the poetry. You know? So we had a lot of time on our hands, and we ended up reading our poems to each other. We went to the car, we went to visit some villages, and then we read more poetry. And he's become like my little brother. Which reminds me, on our way, well, I was walking and he was limping, poor guy. I've never had a big brother. I don't know what it means to have an older brother. And he does, and I asked him, "What's it like?" He said, "It's terrible."
Nah.
This poem is called Victoria. "I love you, for your name is Victoria. For you are free as all that is dark. For you are sweet as all the liqueurs I find and love in the most harmful instinct of daybreak. I love you for when you say, 'Oh, fuck,' your mouth seems to fill with algae and with leaves and with withered butterflies that return to life in the perfection of silence and of rain. I love you for you leave me no other choice but sadness, for you do not believe me, for you couldn't care less about my thirst for transcendence, for you make whips and ropes out of my nerves and syringes of morphine out of my tears. And for your eyes, jack-o'-lanterns at the end of the night in which I stumble. And for your legs, walking frames on towards my death, a cruel vertigo that annihilates me. And for your breasts, brief as the heart attacks of my solitude. And for your mouth, your hallucinated mouth, glimpsed in dream, your strangely open mouth into which enter my sweat, the seed, a blind bird with its white storm upon its shoulders. Your strangely open mouth, after my breath, becomes entangled in your hair, and I fall to the precipice of your sex until I become nothing, nothing but an alcoholic puff. Only this palpitating uncertainty that seeks you, loves you. I love you, for you love what is impossible and what is lost."
Oh, my way, who shall? See, this is just Victoria. Te quiero porque te llamas Victoria, porque eres libre como todo lo oscuro, porque eres dulce como todos los licores que encuentro y amo en el instante más nocivo de la madrugada. Te quiero porque cuando dices carajo, parece que la boca se te llena de algas y de hojas y de mariposas marchitas que volvieran a la vida en la perfección del silencio y de la lluvia. Te quiero porque no me dejas más opción que la tristeza, porque no me crees, porque no te importa mi sed de trascendencia, porque te fabricas látigos y cuerdas con mis nervios y jeringas de morfina con mi llanto. Y también por tus ojos, luces fatuas al final de la noche en que tropiezo, y por tus piernas, andaderas de mi muerte, vértigo cruel que me aniquila, y por tus senos breves con infartos de mi soledad, y por tu boca alucinada, vislumbrada en sueño, tu boca extrañamente abierta, tu boca extrañamente abierta donde entra mi sudor, el mar, un pájaro ciego y su blanca tempestad a cuestas, tu boca extrañamente abierta después de que mi aliento se enreda en tus cabellos y me despeño en el barranco de tu sexo hasta no ser nada, nada, apenas un soplo alcoholizado, solo esta incertidumbre palpitante que te busca, que te ama, te amo, porque amas lo imposible y lo perdido.